This is the 750C display for Bafang e-bikes. I'm Eric. This screen can be used on the BBS01 and the BBS02, and of course the one I got, the BBSHD, which is the 1000-watt version. So pretty much I just need to take off my old screen and then put this one on. And then it easily comes unplugged from the bike. Ah, there it goes. Nice waterproof connectors. And now just put the new screen on there, which is really easy. Everything comes open, so I don't have to take any of the handlebar stuff off. Now I just find the two notches in, line it up, and plug it in. Then to turn it on, you just hold the power button down for about 3 seconds, and the screen will turn on. Welcome! And as you can see, the 750C has a very large display. Just a little confession here, I have been using the screen for a couple years now. I put it on with the Bafang when I first bought it. I've taken the screen out on many, many adventures with me. One of the adventures is I took it right up the mountains north of Phoenix into a little town called Crown King. Then I hooked a solar trailer up to the bike and drove it all the way to Vegas and down the strip with it. So I love this screen. It's really bright and easy to view. It has all the information I need. Time, I use that quite a bit on touring. A percentage for the battery, which it'll do every percentage for that. You got your miles per hour, of course, and your total watts used. It has more information like your trip information. Hit the mode button here. So now you can see it's showing the average speed during the trip and then the maximum mile per hour. By hitting the power button, you can cycle through each thing. And this is where you can see, yeah, I've definitely used this bike quite a bit. You can see the ODO or the odometer's at 4,529 miles. It's the actual motor's higher than that because I've been testing other screens. The motor is at like 4,600. Let's go ahead and hit the power button again. And there you can see the amount of time for the current trip. Then to get into the menu system, you're going to go ahead and hit the mode button or the menu button twice. And now we're into the menu system. This first one that is basically your miles per hour or kilometers is your two option. Next one is your screen brightness, which you can turn that down. Auto off, that's pretty much how long with not touching the bike, how long it take to turn the bike off. So if none of the brakes are pressed, it's not pedaled, it's just sitting there idle. Yeah, it'll end up turning the screen off. Battery indicator, you can switch that voltage and power, or you could turn it off all the way, which I don't know why you would do that. Turn that back to percentage. Next one is the clock. So yeah, it's a little off. So I'm gonna go ahead and set all this.
523.
And that's pretty much it for the display settings. And then we have basic settings. So go ahead and hit the power button to get over to the basic settings. So from here, you can set your wheel diameter. The screen has quite a few options. Let's go through them real quick. So it goes up to 31 inches and then it goes into centimeters, or it'll go down to a 16 inch bike. So I'm gonna put that back at 29. The next one is the battery voltage. And it's like it goes, the screen will do down to 24 and up to 52 volts on that. Of course, this is a 48 volt, so I'm gonna stick on that one. Next one is a password. That's basically where you set the password for your bike. I personally defend my bike in other means, but if you do set that password, make sure you don't forget it because I'm not too sure on how to reset that. In the advanced settings, you can actually set a speed limit for it and the password will be included in the user manual. And that's good if you have kids or something, you want to govern them down to a lower speed limit. Basically, if you want to do a factory reset, that may be able to, I don't think that would bypass the password though. I don't think you can get into the settings. And that's just basic information. I can't tell some of this higher information there, but yeah, you got basic battery information. Yep. The screen did also advertise when I bought it some navigation features. That's a BLE you'll see up there, but after testing them out, I found them to be totally worthless. I wouldn't even buy the screen for any of its navigation features if you do see those ads. So I'm also not going to demonstrate how you get into all that either, because it's just totally pointless. The navigation does not work properly on it. And if you hold the plus button down for a couple seconds, it turns on the headlight for the bike. I currently don't have a headlight on this bike, but you can see the little symbol light up there. And of course, to turn it off, you hold it down again. Then the screen has, like many of the other ones, an auto walk feature. For the auto walk feature, you basically just hold down this bottom button and then the bike starts auto walking. As you can see, I currently got the solar trailer hooked up to it and So yeah, I've already used that screen going up into the mountains here, and I've also used it going to Vegas. So that screen's been tested a lot, 4,600 miles, and it's still going, still shining bright. I've never had any kind of fault with it. It does display also the error codes if you need them too, which is a lot more helpful than some of the ones where they'll just show like an error symbol on them. And if you want to find out more about the solar e-bike, you can check out more of those videos on my channel. The screen is a little bit pricey. It's sometimes priced to closer up to the like $100 range, but I do find it to be one of the better screens for having a nice big bright display. So definitely don't have any problems seeing it. So thanks for watching. You can find a link for this screen down below. Until next time, have a great day.